Hello guys, how are you all? Hope you guys are not having any kind of doubt in my previous video. And today we are going to continue with the characteristics of our constitution. Fourth characteristic of our constitution was left. The fourth characteristic is fundamental rights. Clear? So now first, you must know the meaning of rights, that what are rights. If we talk about the rights, basically they are legal, social or ethical principles. Or you can say that legally, socially and ethically, all the things which are correct in the eyes of law is known as our rights. Clear? So basically we are going to read about seven rights we are having. And the first right is right to equality. The first right is our right to equality. Now, this equality means equal treatment, and which equal treatment on the basis of caste, color, religion, gender, culture, language, and the different things over here. Clear? So this right to equality mainly protect us or give us the equal treatment. That is, protect us from the biasness, from the partialities or the discrimination. Clear? On the basis of this equal treatment, earlier we were having a problem of untouchability. This was an extreme problem in our past, and in this untouchability, basically the lower caste people were not allowed to sit with the higher caste people. Clear? So our constitution consider this untouchability as a illegal kind of practice. And now no one is allowed to follow this kind of untouchability. Clear? But right to equality doesn't mean that we are not allowed to provide some extra benefits to the weaker sections. This right to equality allow us special help to our weaker sections of our society. Clear? So this is all about our right to equality. Next, if we talk about the second right is right to. So in this right to freedom means the people of India, according to the constitution, must have the freedom to enjoy their life and to enjoy the certain benefits. But right to freedom does not allow us to follow the illegal things or to enjoy the illegal concepts of our life. So in this, unwanted restrictions are not there, which means that suppose now as we are having this lockdown and the things are going on, and you will say that, bhai, this is my right that I can move here and there freely. Clear? Mana aapka right hai, you can move here and there freely, but this time it is considered as a wanted restrictions. Ab hamare paas ye restriction hona zaruri hai. Because of this, we can able to protect our nation. According to the time and according to situations, if the things change, then the people of a country are required to follow all these things. Let us have a look from a book about the right to freedom. So here you are having some rights like freedom of speech and expressions, which shows that you can able to express your views, you can able to give the speech over there, and you can able to have assembled peacefully. Abhi to mana hai hamare ko kahin jana, but apart from this, if you want to assemble anywhere, clear, assemble peacefully. Aisa nahi hai ki ladai karne ke liye hum assembled ho rahe hain. If we assemble peacefully anywhere, so this is our right. Fair right to form an association. We are having different trade unions. We are having different NGOs. So in this way, this is our right. We can make associations, and right to move freely throughout the country. Just focus on this throughout the country, not outside the country. If you are going outside the country, you require some visa, passports and all these facilities. Visa specially. Clear? So in this, you can move in your country anywhere without any kind of a restrictions. And right to reside in your country, you can settle down. Kahin bhi apni property khareed sakte ho, kahin bhi business start kar sakte ho apna. Clear? Right to practice any profession, koi bhi business, koi bhi profession aap start kar sakte ho. These are your certain examples regarding your rights over there. But as we talk about our first right is right to freedom of speech and expression, it doesn't mean that you are expressing your views which are harming the other person's, clear? So over here to mention that does not mean that we can say in public and write published things harmful for others. We cannot write down anything which is harmful for others. Right to freedom specifically shows us if we want to enjoy this right, so this right should be enjoyed in this manner that the other party or the other person should not get any kind of harm from this. Clear? So this is about your right to freedom. Now let us come on the third right of our constitution. In this right to freedom, I can, being the citizen of a country, we can follow any of our religion, or you can say that we can practice any of our religion, we can preach any of our religion. Clear? So according to this right, we can able to enjoy, we can practice means हम कहीं भी अपने पूजा कर सकते हैं, हम लोग किसी को अपने religion के बारे में बता सकते हैं, we can able to show the things about the our religion, but we cannot force anyone to change the religion. But if a person above the age of 18 years want to change their religion, then they can change the religion without any kind of a restrictions over there. Clear? Now next come on the fourth right is cultural and educational rights. According to this right, we can follow our culture as well as we can follow any of the language. Clear? And if we talk about the educational right, so we can take our education in any language. It should not be restricted on us. Suppose if I don't want to take education in English, so I can just take an admission in Hindi medium school or Hindi medium college. I can take my education from there. I just want to just know about something Punjabi language, Urdu language, so I can able to take the education in that particular field without having any kind of restriction on us. Nobody can restrict us, like this is the India, you cannot able to speak in the French language, you cannot able to speak in the Japanese language. So it is our right that we can able to learn any of the language if the language is available in our particular area. Clear? Now next fifth right we are having, right against exploitation. In this right against exploitation means misbehave, कोई हमारे साथ गलत कर रहा है. Clear? So we can raise our voice against that and the government can able to find out the solution. I'm giving the example of exploitation, like domestic violence we are having, no? Domestic violence, घरेलू हिंसा जिसे हम बोलते हैं, ठीक है. इन दिस इट इज़ अ एक्सप्लोटेशन, चाइल्ड लेबर. अकॉर्डिंग टू चाइल्ड लेबर, बिलो द एज ऑफ 14 ईयर्स चाइल्ड इज नॉट अलाउ टू डू वर्क ओवर देयर. एंड द बॉन्डेड लेबर, नाउ द वर्ड बॉन्डेड लेबर मीन्स फोर्स लेबर. अर्लियर व्हेन ब्रिटिशर्स वर रूलिंग इन इंडिया, एट दैट टाइम दे वर हैविंग अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स रिगार्डिंग द बॉन्डेड लेबर, एंड इन दिस दे जस्ट force the labor to work under them and they provide less wages as well. Clear? Jitni der kaam karwa rahe, number of working hours are more and the wages are giving very less, so it is considered as a bonded labor. So this is kind of exploitation we are having. So our constitution of India provide us security from the exploitation. If we are facing any kind of exploitation, then we can raise our voice. This is our right. Theek hai? Koi bhi exploitation ko जो है फेस नहीं करना है, वी जस्ट रेज आर वॉइस एंड मेक अ कंप्लेन अगेंस्ट दैट. एंड दीज आर द फाइव राइट्स. लेट अस कम ऑन द सिक्स्थ. सो आर सिक्स्थ राइट इज राइट टू प्राइमरी एजुकेशन. क्लियर? अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस राइट टू प्राइमरी एजुकेशन, गवर्नमेंट मेक्स सर्टेन प्रोग्राम्स एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस the children from the age of 6 to 14 years are having a full right to take education either from the government institute or from the private institutes. Clear? And basically free education is provided by the government in the primary schools, and that's what is considered as a primary education from the age of 6 to 14 years of a children. And for this the government introduced a system which was named as सर्व शिक्षा अभियान मीन्स द एज फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 6 टू 14 ईयर्स एवरी चाइल्ड इज हैविंग अ राइट टू टेक अ फ्री एजुकेशन फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी स्कूल्स. क्लियर? नाउ आवर लास्ट राइट इज राइट टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडी. आई जस्ट कंसिडर इट एज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट राइट बिकॉज इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग दिस राइट then it is a totally failure of the other rights we are having. And in this right to constitutional remedies, according to this, everybody can appeal in a court. Everybody can appeal in a court if a particular person is deprived. Deprived means agar usko roka ja raha hai fundamental rights follow karne ke liye. Clear? So in that particular situation, a particular person can appeal in a court against the particular group, particular person, or against a particular minister's police force also, that this particular person is forcing me not to follow my fundamental rights. Clear? That's why according to me, this right is considered as the father of all rights. Why so? Likhna nahi aapne, but I'm just telling you. Father of all the rights, because of this right we can able to manage each and everything. Agar ye right nahi hai to hum kisi ke against koi complaint nahi kar sakte. So guys, now two topics of our chapter is left. Let us have a look over here, the directive principles of a state policies. Now everything when it is mentioned in our constitution, clear? So somehow at a very primary stage, at a very initial stage, it is mentioned in some of the, it is not finalized as it is. Okay, jab koi naya program policy hoga, to we just take a trial for this. Clear? So at this time, the framers of our constitution, that means the Constituent Assembly, focus on some of the guidelines or the goals for the future, and these guidelines are known as our directive principles of state policies. Clear? Jaise ki examples again, laws have passed, that is the right to primary education, on the protection of environment. So these are some directive principles which we are following, which we just make it so that we firstly we just make a trial, then we can consider it as a final right. Clear? Now fundamental rights we read about. Next is our fundamental duties. Some of the according to 42nd Amendment Act in the Constitution, which is made in 1976, and we are having some of the rights over here, like to abide by the Constitution. We are restricted by the Constitution and we need to respect our ideals, our national flags and our national anthem. Clear? So these are some fundamental rights. To cherish and follow the noble ideals. What are the noble ideals or the freedom struggles we were having? We must follow or cherish them. We must protect the sovereignty, unity and the integrity of our India. We must protect our country, as well as if we just find out that our country want our service. So this is our particular right or duty. Yes, we need to give this particular service to our country to promote harmony. Harmony means unity, and to encourage the spirit of brotherhood. For the brotherhood, again I will use the same statement, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, aapas mein hai bhai bhai. Clear? We must promote all these things and value and preserve the heritage, like the culture we are following. We must give the value and we must preserve it. Preserve means कोई एक्सटर्नल फोर्स आके हमारे से हमारा कल्चर ना ले ले. एंड टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड इम्प्रूव द नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट. दिस इज आवर ड्यूटीज विच वी नीड टू फॉलो एंड विच वी नीड टू कवर अप, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज नॉट इन द हैंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. सम आर आवर मॉरल ड्यूटीज ऑल्सो. क्लियर? सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट योर चैप्टर. द चैप्टर इज फिनिश्ड नाउ एंड let us meet in our next video with the next chapter. Till then, take care, bye bye, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe my video. If you like my video, you just comment on that. If you want to give me any suggestions, then you can give the suggestions. Your suggestions are also most welcome over there. Bye bye guys.